Cal Martin chose a great song to walk out to today. Coming down from 8 points, Muay Thai, with Cliff Clockfelter as his head striking coach. We have Kyle Martin coming down.
Coming out in the typical Muay Thai attire.
Kyle Martin is sporting an unblemished 4-0 record at the young age of 20 years old. Hailing out of North Carolina. Making his second appearance and title contention right here in the Fight Lab cage again. Last time he was in here, he had a unanimous decision against Sheldon Sales in January. Winning all three rounds, 29-28. Once again, coming out with his traditional Muay Thai attire. Kyle Martin sporting a nice tattoo that says determined across his back. Once again, this young man is 20 years of age fighting for a title. It is surprising me at the age these guys are starting to come out and making title contentions in the area. John Henning sporting a 5-4 record. A little upside down, does not reflect the fighter he is currently. He started off his career 0-2, and turned that back around in the last 2 years, and become pretty dominant. His last fight was over Rodney Jordan. I remember that one. It was the third round. I think Rodney Jordan went for a low kick and
hurt his leg.
Yep. Yeah. Okay. And John checked it. John is pretty proficient at his kicks as well. So this will be a very, very interesting dynamic fight seeing these two strikers go at it. There's the last person to beat John Henning is actually Jared Miller. Jared Miller comes from an extensive background in wrestling, which can try and nullify what John Henning does. I just don't see that happening today from Kyle Martin. It doesn't look in his attire that he's ready to take anything down to the ground. This should be a back and forth brawl between two great strikers. So Corey, tell me what goes to your mind right now as you get Vaseline'd up right before you get into the cage.
I gotta tell you, man, I'll get a little bit of anxiety and stuff leading up to a fight. A couple weeks out's the worst, but it all goes away when I get to walk down that runway, get to get my clothes off, get greased up. That's the most confident I am the entire time. When I step into the cage, it's go time. I mean, there's nothing else. All I'm thinking about at that point is getting my breath right. You know, I want to slow my heart rate down as much as I can. I really focus on breathing in through my nose and just relaxing, slowing that heart rate down, because you know it's going to be pump, 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 pump.
Absolutely.
Impressive, undefeated record of 4 wins versus no defeat. This young man comes to us from Charlotte, North Carolina. He carries an impressive MMA record of 6 wins, but since 4 defeats, representing East Coast Fighter and Charlotte Jiu-Jitsu Academy, East Coast and Charlotte, put your hands together for Todd Keating!
All right, Joe. It's our last title fight of the evening, is that correct?
No, it is not.
Second title fight of the evening. Second of three. I would assume we're about to see a stand-up match here. I could be very wrong, though. What do you think, Joe?
I totally agree with you. Like I said before, these guys don't typically look like grapplers. I know for a fact that John Henning does not really care to grapple. He'd rather keep it standing if all possible. That's where he's more comfortable at. So it's going to be a very, very exciting fight.
Both guys filling each other out in the middle of the ring to start.
Kyle coming out with that nice, powerful kick out first. John testing out the waters. Jab getting his range down.
Oh, nice.
Kyle's not afraid to throw those kicks. Comes in hard every time. There's literally no fear in that young man's face.
Throws that kick again. That's the third body kick we've seen.
No.
Both guys exchange leg kicks.
Well, absolutely. Nice trade off there. Martin has a very, very good head movement.
Oh, there we go.
Barely
our first takedown of the evening.
John Henning has a half butterfly, keeping Kyle pinned down. Not a lot going on there. Pretty much hold him down, not wanting to give space up for good reason. Kyle's very, very quick.
Kyle relaxed, trying to soften him up, working the body, working the head. Back to the body, back to the head. Both fighters relaxed, under control. John Henning keeping a tight, close guard. Neither fighter really working too hard to improve position right here.
No.
As soon as I say that, John Henning goes for throws that leg over.
Can't see from this angle what he's going for on that far side. But Kyle Martin is pretty much staying stuck on his hip, not trying to give him any space.
He's on the right side of the card, so he would have been a blue card.
Kyle Martin now at Phoenix half guard, still trying to soften him up with body shots. Again, neither fighter looking to do anything crazy here.
Henning looking to push that knee, try to create some space, maybe get for an escape right here. But he has to let go of that head. Right now, all he's doing is having that head hook, just keeping the pin down on top of him. These guys have to realize that these are 4-minute rounds, not 3-minute rounds anymore, and they have 5 of them.
Henning gets it back to full guard, controlling Martin's head from the bottom. Martin still trying to soften him up with little shots. Henning puts his left foot in Martin's hip, back to full guard. Throws a leg over, looks like he's got a triangle right here.
But no arm, it's just a naked triangle. And it's tight. I'm not sure he can finish it here because it's not enough space.
And he's not going to.
It wasn't constricted enough off of either arteries. Oh. Now he's in a bad position. Martin with a nice hard right to the sternum, to the step. Oh man, he's in bad position right here. Henning had to move quickly.
Henning got out of there quick.
Into a half guard, almost locked down position, or locking down the half guard. Martin staying in really, really good position, not putting himself in bad position at all. And that is in the first round.
So Kyle Martin takes that round without a doubt.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. That was a good-looking round. Kind of surprised that Kyle Martin went for that takedown. Even though when he scored it, he was in great position. Kyle Martin's corner, I would tell him to do exactly what you just did. And if I was a John Henry's corner, we have the pressure. We have to keep him honest. The moment he can close that gap and take us down is when we're losing.
Absolutely. Kyle Martin looked great that first round. Slow and methodical. There was a method to his madness. He landed a couple good shots from the top.
John is doing very good with that jab. He's getting in with that deep kick.
Oh. Stuffs that takedown pretty easy with double underhooks right there.
Oh, absolutely. Kyle Martin came in looking like a 757, arms wide out, elbows all the way up. It was very, very easy for John Henning to stick both double unders up and suck him right back up to his feet.
John Henning not working too hard to get off the cage here. He needs to jack up that left underhook, turn to his left. Guys fighting for position. Kyle Martin drops down for a double. He's going to look to suck him back off the cage.
Nice change.
And there he goes. See him posture up and rain down some shots right here.
Kyle Martin is showing great versatility here. It's not that often where you see a guy in traditional Muay Thai shorts pin somebody against the cage, drop down with a level change, going for a double leg, and actually scoring it.
This is true. I'd like to see him posture up here a little bit or even stand up and pinch his legs and rain down some shots.
Absolutely.
Right
now, I think Kyle's playing it safe by staying tight and just hitting those rapid punches. Right now, he's in no immediate danger. I think at this point, he's totally comfortable with taking these rounds just by doing what he's doing right now.
And I'm going to tell you right now, from my view right here, Joe, I can see John Henning talking to Kyle Martin from the bottom position. I don't know what he's saying because he's getting punched in the face repeatedly, but he's saying something.
Can't be anything
throws
good.
That leg over, goes for another triangle attempt. This is the third time we've seen this tonight. He's got an arm in this time, Joe.
Absolutely. Good reposition, get an angle. Kyle Martin's letting get up that angle. You see how he's bowed over? If John Henning can get to his foot, he's in deep trouble here.
He's got that tight. The arms across, he's got it tight.
Martin trying to stop it up, and the tap! Talking about changing the dynamic of a fight. Kyle Martin dominated the whole first round. Minor tweaking by his professor right there, John Piper, his jiu-jitsu coach over there at East Coast Fighter.
You can tell Kyle's disappointed in himself. He knows he was in great position. He's winning the fight. He got caught there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You cannot discredit that because he was going after something.
That was the third triangle attempt for John Henning. Third time paid off.
That was a great job adjusting in between rounds to lock in that submission victory.
What?
Ecstatic. Dream come true.
Now, over the years since I've known you, the biggest hiccup or complaint on you or strike against you was, you know, you're a phenomenal striker, you move good, but your grappling's never been up to par. Now, I see some grappling royalty over in your corner, Professor John Piper. How much did you guys work on that triangle? Because I saw you going after it a couple times.
I mean, not necessarily the triangle, that's my thing. That's probably my best bowling ground, but I spent probably more time on the ground this game than I had in there. So, Piper's bringing me along.
Anybody do a thing?
I want to thank Crew, Piper, Van Gaal, everybody else on East Coast Fighter for working with me. My family, both my family, and also the Del Montoya, the Silver Fly.
He helped me get in here tonight. And he's
there, and
I'm
following. So,
I
think that's about everybody.
No, I don't need him.
Ladies and gentlemen, a man of very few words.
Oh, you got
to
when I leave, I'll
take him home. Your new champion, Akuma John Heaney!
In today's economy, your image is more important than ever. Make the most of your first impression. Tri-County Printing Solutions is a full-service print shop right here in Western North Carolina. With on-site equipment and expert staff, we are able to print, cut, mount, and prepare all your custom sign and graphic needs. With personal service, fast turnaround, quantity discounts, no minimums, no setup or layout fees, we will meet your needs. Take your business to the next level with Tri-County Printing Solutions.
Hungry and just looking for old-fashioned diner food? Then come to Maddie's Diner. Maddie's Diner is a neighborhood diner that transports you back in time so you can enjoy remembering the way things used to be. Located at the NC Music Factory, this fully restored 1950s diner was literally relocated from New Jersey and serves some of the best food in town. Our menu includes breakfast that is served all day, burgers, sandwiches, and dinner entrees. Don't leave without tasting our homemade desserts or one of our milkshakes, the best in Charlotte. Our motto is good food with attitude. So no matter if you come early or late night, at Maddie's Diner, you're always family.